guys, and welcome back to bbnbb yoga. I'm Zabi. I'm really happy that you're joining me today. Today's flow is full of deep and big stretches, so if you're sitting around quite a lot, this one is perfect for you. So let's get started. We're gonna start today in Virasana, to the top of our mats. So come to a seated position on your shins. This is difficult on your knees. Maybe you want to use a blanket just to make it a bit softer. And then just take a moment here. Maybe you want to close the eyes. Maybe you want to soften your gaze. Awareness within, tuning into your breath, noticing where the mind is at, noticing how you're feeling today. Deepening the inhalations and exhalations. Finding a moment of calmness before we start moving. Maybe finding an intention for your practice today. Maybe you want to dedicate it to someone you love. Someone that makes you stronger. Then let's take a deep inhale all together through the nose. Fill up the lungs, feel the belly and the chest rise. Open your mouth and exhale, sigh it all out. Once again, deep full inhale through the nose all the way to the top. Open the mouth and let it go. One last time, deep full inhale through the nose all the way to the very, very top. Open the mouth and exhale, release. Lovely. Softly blink your eyes open if they were closed. And then interlacing your fingers, bringing your hands towards the sky, finding a nice stretch here through your spine. Start opening through the heart, hugging the belly and the ribs in. And then as you exhale, bring your hands forward, draw them away from your body as you round through the spine, really separating the shoulder blades, slightly tucking your chin towards your chest. And then as you inhale, we lengthen through the spine, hands reach towards the sky, gaze towards the sky as you hug the belly and the ribs in, finding length here, opening through the heart. And then exhale, round through the spine, push the hands away. Once again, inhale to lengthen, opening through the heart. And then exhale, round through the spine. Really pushing your hands away from your body, separating the shoulder blades. And inhale, brings you back to center. Release your hands and then lift your hips up. So we're engaging through the glutes here. Toes can be tucked or on top, whatever feels best for you here. And we slide our right hand down our right thigh. And as we inhale, we reach our left arm across the ear, finding length here through the side body, opening through the left shoulder, just getting a nice stretch here. Glutes are engaged. And coming all the way up. Now left hand reaches down left thigh. Right arm reaches across. Find length here, opening through the right shoulder. Coming all the way up. Right hand reaches down, left hand reaches across. And back to center, left hand down, left thigh, right arm reaches across. Find length, find space. And one more time on each side. So right arm down, left arm reaches across. Find length through the side body. And then left side one last time. So left arm reaches down your left thigh, right arm reaches across. Beautiful. Inhale brings you back to center. Now we're all gonna tuck our toes. And we're gonna come into a... No, actually, let's reach our arms out in front of us. Now really engaging through the glutes. So squeeze your bum, engaging the core, hugging the belly and the ribs in. Lift the pelvic floor. Arms reach forward. Now we're just gonna lean back as much as feels good to you. Holding it here and coming all the way up again. Let's do this again. So we lean back, strong core, strong glutes. I know this is heavy on the legs. Coming all the way up. One last time. Gonna lean back. Awesome job, guys. We're gonna come all the way forward. And this time, as we lean back, we're gonna lift our knees off and come into a yogi squat. So come all the way back, lift the knees off the ground. You need to use your hands. That's totally fine. We're gonna find our squat. Maybe you need to heel toe your feet slightly apart for this. Finding length through the spine, using your elbows to press your knees outwards. Start opening up through the hips. We're just gonna take a moment here. So a few breaths in our squat. And then releasing our fingertips towards the ground. We're gonna start straightening out through the legs, finding a ragdoll here. So releasing any tension in the lower back, head and shoulders relax. Feet can be either mat width distance apart or about hip width distance apart. Shifting the weight into the balls of our feet, you can either grab opposite elbows or bring your hands behind your back. Whatever feels good to you, right here, right now. Listen to your body. You know your body best. Move in a way that feels good to you. Maybe you want to bend into one knee, bend into the other, sway the hips. Lovely yogis. With your next exhale, release your fingertips towards the ground. Bring your right hand to your left ankle, bending into the right knee. We reach the left arm towards the sky, finding a twist here, opening through the left shoulder. And coming all the way down, releasing the fingers. Bringing the left hand to the right ankle, bending into our left knee. We reach the right arm towards the sky. Lovely, releasing it down. And then we do one more time on each side. So right hand, left ankle bend into the right knee, left arm reaches towards the sky. And releasing it down, left hand, right ankle, right arm towards the sky. Lovely. Exhale, release, slight bend in both knees. Chin towards the chest, we roll ourselves all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae, and find our mountain pose. Shoulders roll up, back and down as we come up. Now heel toe your feet to touch, or keep them hip width distance. Take an inhale here and sweep the arms high towards the sky. Grab your right wrist with your left hand, sliding the right hand behind the left, drawing the hands over to the left side, sending the hips towards the right, finding a nice and deep side stretch here. Now releasing it down, coming back to center. Inhale, arms sweep high. This time grabbing your left wrist with your right hand, slide that left leg behind the right as you draw your hands over to the left side. Left hip draws towards the left side for an even deeper stretch. And releasing the hands. Take another inhale here as we sweep the arms high towards the sky. This time as we exhale, we fold forward, hinging from the hips. Inhale to a long spine, gaze comes up. And exhale, we plant the hands, step the right foot back, heel toeing the left foot out towards the outer edge of the mat. We find our lizard lunge. So either staying here, maybe you want to draw some circles to open up through the left hip, getting a nice stretch through the right hip flexor, stretching the right ankle. Maybe you want to come onto the outer edge of your left foot, bring your left hand to your knee to open up even deeper. Whatever feels good to you here. Moving away, that feels good to you. Lovely. Then planting the hands down, stepping it back into plank. Hold your plank, strong core. External rotation in the shoulders, hollowing through the front body. Crown of the head reaches forward as the heels draw back. Now as we exhale, we shift our hips up towards the sky, finding a down dog. As we do this, bring your left hand to your right ankle. Inhale, coming back into plank. Exhale, down dog, left hand, right ankle. Inhale, back to plank, and once again, sending the hips back, left hand, right ankle, finding a twist, and coming all the way forward into plank. Hold it here for a breath. So full inhale, and exhale. And then we lower our knees, lower our chest, lower our chin. Tuck the pelvis, ripple forward into cobra. Elbows draw towards each other, engaging through the glutes, lengthening through the heart. Draw your hands back to really send your heart forward. And then tucking the toes, sending the hips back, downward facing dog. Lovely yogis. Take a moment here, pedaling out the feet. Finding your alignment, finding your breath, finding your intention. Next inhale, come high into the balls of your feet, bend the knees, gaze between the hands. We tiptoe all the way forward to the top of our mat. Finding a ragdoll here once again, this time keeping a bend in both knees, melting your chest towards your thighs. Maybe you want to walk your hands forward away from your body, getting a nice deep stretch through your back, through the sides of your body. Head and shoulders relax. Shifting the weight into the balls of our feet. Releasing tension in the lower back. Bringing our fingers back in, chin towards the chest, we roll ourselves all the way up, vertebrae by vertebrae, rolling the shoulders up, back and down as we come up. Lovely. Inhale, arms sweep high towards the sky. This time, grab your left wrist with your right hand, sliding the left hand behind the right first, finding our stretch. Shifting the hips over to the left. And coming back to center. Inhale, arms sweep high. Grab your right wrist with your left hand. Right leg slides behind the left. Shifting the right hip towards the right for an even deeper stretch. Lovely, coming back to center, releasing the hands and then inhaling them back up. Exhale, hinging from the hips, we fold forward. Inhale to a halfway lift, long spine, gaze comes up. And then planting the hands and stepping the left foot back. Heel turning the right foot out towards the outer edge of your mat. Maybe start drawing circles here in your lizard lunge. Maybe you want to bring your right hand to your right knee. Coming onto the outer edge of your right foot for an even deeper opening in the right hip. Feel the stretch in your left hip flexor. Start stretching through the left ankle. And then planting the right hand down, stepping the right foot back into a plank. Find a strong plank here. Hollowing through the front body, external rotation in the shoulders. I'm gonna shift our hips back as we exhale, bringing our right hand to our left ankle. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale, send it back, find your twist. Inhale back to plank, one last time. Sending the hips back, right hand to left ankle. Inhale all the way forward, hold with your plank, really engaging the core, and then lowering the knees, chest, chin, tucking the pelvis, coming into cobra, drawing the elbows towards each other, engaging through the glutes, lengthening through the spine, opening the heart, and tucking the toes, sending the hips back. Downward facing dog. Beautiful yogis, stay in your down dog for one more breath. Deep inhale through the nose. Open your mouth at the very top and exhale, sigh it out. Lovely. Lowering your knees down towards the mat. Coming into Virasana once again, just as we started. Let's lift our hips up, take an inhale here, sweep the arms high towards the sky, exhale, hands to heart. Take an inhale, cactusing the arms, so drawing the arms back, bringing the shoulder blades towards each other, opening through the heart, maybe gaze up, and then exhale, we're lower our hips down, round through the spine. Inhale, we lift up and cactus the arms, engaging the glutes. And exhale, we lower down, rounding through the spine. Inhale, we lift and cactus. And exhale, we round. Let's do this once again. Inhale, we lift and cactus. And exhale, we round. Lovely yogis. coming forward into a tabletop, just to walk our hands even further forward. We're gonna come into puppy pose. Start melting your chest towards the ground, maybe bringing your forehead onto the mat. Feeling the stretch through the spine, through the sides of your body. And then lifting the gaze, threading your right hand underneath your left, bringing your right shoulder, right ear towards the ground. Maybe you want to walk that left hand slightly over to the right for an even deeper stretch, or even bring it all the way around to the top of your right thigh, finding a little bind here, opening through the left shoulder. Lovely, bringing the left hand out long, pressing it to the left hand, bringing the right hand back forward, and then we do the left side. So left arm threads underneath the right, lowering the left shoulder, left ear towards the mat. Maybe the right hand walks over to the left. Maybe you want to bring it all the way around to meet your left thigh, opening through the right shoulder. Lovely. Bringing the right hand forward once again, pressing into the right hand to release the left hand. And then we're just gonna sink back into child's pose. Lovely yogis, take as much time in your child's pose as feels good to you. I'm gonna end this video right here. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you again soon.